So I have a bunch of stock tickers here, and I want to create a f individual folder for each one. You can see I've already started it here by going new folder and just typing in the symbol for each one. But after about 10, it gets a little tiresome, and I want to know how to create all of these folders all at once without having to do that. So how we're going to do that is we're going to go into Terminal here. And it's going to come up here, and so what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to navigate to this area of our computer. So in order to see where we're at, we're going to type in dir. That's going to pull up the files, and then we're just going to take it one step at a time. So in order to change the directory, which means go to the correct place, we're going to do cd. I'm just going to keep repeating. All right, so I'm there now, and these are the documents I have. And so this article right here talks about how to do this. And you can find it here on instructables.com. The code is MD, which I assume stands for Make Directory. Then we enter all of the ticker symbols that we want. So I'm going to do that, and I'll be back. So I have the tickers here in Excel. And probably the easiest way to go about this instead of typing it in to the terminal one at a time would be this is in Power Query, so I'm gonna come up here to Power Query. I'm gonna see if I can format this inside the Excel file. So these are the tickers here. I'll transform and I can hit transpose, and that's gonna turn it. Then I can copy this row, and when I right click, it doesn't do anything. So I'm going to hit Control C on the keyboard, and then I'm going to close out without saving anything. I'm going to come here and paste it. All right, so now I just tried this, and what'll happen is when we paste this in, it pastes all the tickers in, but there's no space. So we want there to be a space in between. So we're going to use the concat formula, and how this works is it's going to mesh all of these together. So we're starting at bf.b, and that's the first one we're going to want. And then to place a space between it, we're going to hit quotation space and then quotation, and that's going to be in between every single ticker. So I'm going to do that, and then I'll be back. All right, so now that I've got these in here, I'm going to come over here and paste this in here. Okay, so I'm going to do all right, so you can see it ran that first one there that I tried, so all I'm going to do is come in here and delete this one. And there we go. To show how you would transpose it without Power Query, I've got four tickers right here. I'm going to copy these. I'm going to come over here. I'm going to click right click, paste special. I'm going to check the transposed box, click OK, and now they're transposed.